Hello everybody, Ryan here from Manhattan Prep with an expert level GRE problem for you to try. Take a couple minutes and then we'll figure it all out together. Alright, tough one, right? What makes it tough? Right off the bat, multiple figures. You're not going to see multiple figures in an easy level GRE problem. You'll see a single figure, and maybe you'll have some hard stuff to do with it, but a single figure is exponentially less difficult than multiple figures, because in multiple figures, you need to know both shapes well enough to know how you can pass information from one of those shapes to the other. But what else makes this problem hard? It's not that it gives us an abundance of information. In fact, there's only one piece of information given to us, 20 pi. It's a good habit, by the way, to be in with geometry problems. When you see a word that has a formula attached to it, circumference, for instance, write out that formula. Have it at the ready, because they're never giving you circumference just to talk about circumference. No, they would much rather watch you jump through a silly hoop to get to diameter or radius or area instead. The circumference is just there to make your life one layer more complicated, because that's how the GRE rolls. That's not so bad though. One piece of information to work with, we can work with it. We have the formula there, it's gonna be okay. Nah, it's in the next sentence that the real rub comes. It asks, which of the following is the maximum possible area of the rectangle? And that throws some things into doubt. Now granted, it's a geometry figure on the GRE. You never really trust that it's drawn to scale. You don't look at that and say, I am looking at reality right now. They're giving you a vague indication of where things are relative to each other. The rectangle's inside the circle. Now we know. But this maximum possible area thing is a little bit complicated. What does it take to maximize a rectangle? Well, it turns out that polygons have this one pattern that goes through all the shapes, really. For any given shape, you're going to maximize your area by making all the sides equal. So for a triangle, for instance, you're going to get the maximum area for any given perimeter by making that triangle equilateral. Three equal sides, three equal angles, maximum area. For a rectangle, the only special rectangle really out there, don't tell the other rectangles I said this, is a square. And of course, a square is also the rectangle with four equal sides. So when they talk about the maximum possible area of the rectangle, what they're really getting at is, make this rectangle a square. And now figure out the area of that. And of course, as we said, area is a geometry formula word. We want to have that formula out there waiting for us, but now we know the secret. It's not length times width the way a rectangle normally is. Because this is a square, we're just looking for side squared. All right, that may well be, but how do we find it? We're gonna have to come back to our one hard piece of information in this problem, the fact that the circumference is 20 pi, literally the only number given to us in the problem, so it must be something. And indeed, as we said before, we're gonna have to develop it into something else. If we divide both sides by 2 pi, for instance, we'll get just the straight up radius of 10. Now, is the radius all that useful to us? Perhaps not. If you try to think about where you'd place the radius in any of the classical senses, like that's a radius up there, hard to say which of these 10 units is part of the rectangle and which part's outside the rectangle. It's really hard, therefore, to translate that 10 to one of the sides. Well, this leads to big hidden geometry fact number two. When you've got a quadrilateral inside a circle, there is only one thing they really want you to do. They want you to use the diagonal of that quadrilateral, because the diagonal of that quadrilateral is going to be equal to the diameter of the circle. It goes from one edge of the circle to the other, but it's all sideways. Nobody sees it coming until now. We've got a diameter here of 20 if our radius was 10. But the other thing that does for us is the thing that we'll see in a lot of just straight up rectangle problems. You draw a diagonal in that rectangle because now you've made two right triangles and you can use Pythagoras. You could even, because this is a square, use your 45, 45, 90 identity. Which one's better to use? Look at our goal. We're trying to get s squared here, right? If we use 45, 45, 90, we'll be able to solve for a side pretty directly. If we were looking for perimeter, heck yeah. But if we're looking for s squared, probably better to just use Pythagoras, because s squared is part of the Pythagorean theorem. Here it would be s squared plus s squared equals 20 squared. Do a little bit of squaring and combining and whatnot. You'll get 2s squared equals 400. Divide both sides by 2, and you're left with exactly what we're looking for. S squared, the area, equaling 200. Boom. Answer. All right. What are the big things to take away from this one if you want to operate at that expert level on the GRE? One, for any given polygon, you're going to get the maximum area if you make that polygon a perfect polygon. Make all the sides equal. Equilateral triangle, square, the most perfect of all rectangles, even for pentagons and hexagons. If you make all the sides and all the angles equal, you're going to get the maximum area for those shapes. Thing number two, anytime you see a quadrilateral drawn inside a circle, get that diagonal out there. It's going to be the diameter of the circle, and that makes it the one place where the circle and the quadrilateral have some common grounds. Subscribe for more GRE Math Spotlight videos from Manhattan Prep. And leave us a comment letting us know how you solved it. Happy studying.